Hello everyone. In last video, we have seen the sign rule. You will find that video in I button. Okay. Now today we will see the cosine rule. So first we will see the statement. In triangle ABC, A square equals to B square plus C square minus twice BC cos of A. Okay, this is first statement. There are three statements for cosine rule. Second is, now logically with the help of this statement you can find this. Now here A square, so here it is cos A. Here it is B square, so we will have here cos of B. And because cos of A, no A is present anywhere there. So here it is B, so we will take here A square plus C square minus twice AC. Okay, logically you can find it, you can write it. Then C square, C square, so we will write here cos C, and here A square plus B square twice AC. In this way you can keep this in mind. Okay, now these are the three statements for cosine rule. So first we will try to understand the statements. Okay, so what is this A square, this B square, this C square? In previous videos I have explained these notations. If you miss those, then you can find it on I button. Okay,
let us start the proof.
So this is a triangle. We will take our vertex A here, B and C. Okay. Now we have seen this AB means we have considered as C. The length of AB we have considered as C. The length of AC is B and length of BC is A. Now for the proof of this cosine rule, we will take this A as origin and x-axis along this side AB. Okay, this is x-axis. We will draw a perpendicular at A to x-axis and that will be our y-axis. Okay, now we will consider the polar coordinates of this C. We know that generally we take xy, this distance is y, this distance is x. But here for this proof particularly, we want the polar coordinates of this C. We have seen the relation between polar coordinates and Cartesian coordinates. That is also on I button if you miss that. So what is X? Now here angle is A and this distance is B. Therefore the polar coordinates of C are B cos A, means X equals to B cos A and Y equals to B sin A. Okay? Now we want this first A square means this distance A. Okay, we want the distance BC. So we need the coordinates of B also. Now this distance is C. So the coordinates of B are C0. Now we know the coordinates of B, the coordinates of C. Easily we can find the distance BC. Okay, so what is our first statement? A square. So we will consider as let A square equals to BC square. Okay, now using distance formula, find out the distance between BC. BC is C minus B cos of A. Means here axis of B is C and here it is B cos A. We are considering here polar coordinates. So C minus B cos A square plus here ordinate is 0 and here ordinate is B sin square. Now expand these squares. C square plus B square cos square A minus twice BC cos of A. And here it is simply B square sin square A. Now from these two terms we will take B square common. First C square plus B square in bracket cos square a plus sin square a. This term as it is. Minus twice we see cos of a. Therefore, c square plus b square. Now, cos square a plus sin square a equals to 1 by first fundamental identity. Minus twice bc cos of a. So, here it is a square. So, a square equals to b square plus c square minus twice bc cos of a. So, this is
the proof.
This can also be written as cos of a. If you try to find the value of cos of a from this statement, then b square plus c square, this a square here minus a square upon twice bc. This is another way for cosine rule. Okay. Now here we have considered a as origin for first statement. If you consider b as origin, then you will get second. And if you consider c as origin, we will get third statement. Okay. Understood? Now this is cosine rule. In next video, we will see the projection rule. Thank you.